गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर किरण पोद्दार, अंगड़ी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, बेलगावी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ कंसेप्ट ऑफ फोर ईयर सीरीज ऑफ इवन एंड ऑड फंक्शंस। व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस इवन एंड ऑड फंक्शन? बिकॉज ऑलरेडी इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन वी सॉल्व्ड एग्जाम्पल्स टू ऑब्टेन अ फोर ईयर सीरीज फ्रॉम अ गिवन फंक्शन, वेयर वी डिड्यूस्ड अ फोर ईयर सीरीज by calculating the values of a0, an, bn, then we substituted those values in a given series to obtain a Fourier series. There we calculated all the values like a0, an, bn. But if we try to check out the nature of the given function, whether it is odd or even, then it helps us to calculate the result in a quick manner. That is the importance of checking out the nature of odd and even function. So here first we go through the definition of odd and even nature of the given function. A function f of x is said to be even. When we can say it is even? If f of minus x is equal to f of x. Means what? Here we are going to replace the function x, the variable x, by minus x. Then also the nature of the function will remain same as f of x. Then we say it is even. For example, we can take x square, x raised to 4, x raised to 6, and so on, cos x. If we take x square, we can check it out. In a given function, if the function is f of x is equal to x square, where if we replace x by minus x, then also minus x the whole square will be x square only. Minus x raised to 4 will be x raised to 4 only. So similarly, x raised to 6. Now the question comes whether cos x is a really even function or not. For that, let us check it out. If we take f of x is equal to cos x, as per this concept, if x is been replaced by minus x, then we will be getting cos of minus x. As per the trigonometric identities, we know that cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. So it becomes cos x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to cos x, which is again nothing but f of x. Therefore, cos x is always even function. This is the meaning. Next, a function f of x is said to be odd. When it is possible? If f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Means if x is being replaced by minus x, then the given function will remain as it is with opposite sign. For example, x cube, x raised to 5, and so on up to sin x. If x is been replaced by minus x, if it is taken as f of x and x is been replaced by minus x, then what we will be getting? We will be getting minus x. Therefore, that will be treated as minus of f of x. So that will be odd function. Similarly, x raised to any odd number, if we take, that will be odd. For example, if f of x is equal to sin x, if x is been replaced by minus x, then it becomes sin of minus x. As per the trigonometric functions, we know that sin of minus theta is equal to minus sin theta. Therefore, it is minus of sin x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to minus sin x. But we know that sin x is nothing but f of x, but it is along with minus function. So it is minus of f of x. Therefore, always sin will be odd function. So this is the meaning of odd and even nature of the function. Okay, but the question comes, when we can replace x by minus x? That is the question mark now. Because all the time, is it possible to replace or no? All the time we cannot replace x by minus x to check it out the nature of the function, whether it is odd or even. If our Fourier function, the given function, if it is between minus pi to plus pi, then we can replace x by minus x. Because we know that in a Fourier series, we have two different intervals. One is between minus pi to plus pi, another one is between 0 to 2 pi. If it is 0 to 2 pi, that time we cannot replace x by minus x. That we will discuss later. But right now, keep it in the mind, to obtain a nature of the given function, x will be replaced by minus x if the given function is between the interval minus pi to plus pi. Then we have a few properties to understand further. First, the product of two even functions or odd functions. The product of two even functions or odd functions. But the condition is both are even or both are odd. Is always even. If we are taking a product of two even functions or product of two odd functions, then its result will always, it will be that product will be even. If we take a product of one odd and one even function, that will be always odd. It is like sign operations. Plus of plus will be plus, minus of minus will be plus, plus of minus will be minus, minus of plus will be minus. Means product of odd and odd will be even, even and even will be even, odd and even will be odd, even and odd will be odd. This is the first property. Then second important property, if integration between minus a to plus a of pi of x with respect to x is equal to, it is a standard result, it is 2 times integration from 0 to a pi of x dx. If pi of x is even, it will be 0 if pi of x is odd. This is the standard result what we have. What it says, if the integration is between minus a to plus a of pi of x dx, it will be, in this, after checking out the nature of the given function, if it has been proved it is odd or even, if it is even, that result can be taken as integration between 0 to a. We can observe here the given limit is between minus a to plus a. In between there will be a 0. But when we understand the given function is even, then what happens? Instead of taking minus a to plus a, we take 0 to a, and 0 to a, and it will be multiplied by 2 times. Means one result between 0 to a into 2 will be again from minus a to plus a. So that is the advantage. Suppose if the given function is odd, then automatically the value of that entire function will become 0. Directly we can calculate, we can say that will be 0 without any calculation part. That is the importance. For example, in this case, we know that in a Fourier series, the Fourier series of the given function f of x, is defined in the interval between minus pi to plus pi, where we have a values for a naught, a n, b n. A naught is taken as 1 by pi integration between minus pi to plus pi into f of x dx, and a n will be taken as 1 by pi integration from minus pi to plus pi into f of x into cos nx dx. Similarly, bn will be taken as 1 by pi integration from minus pi to plus pi f of x sin nx dx. Then the question comes, if this is true, then what will be the result after checking out the nature of the given function, whether it is odd or even? Okay, so let us see what happens now. If the function is odd or if the function is even, how these previous results changes? Okay, we'll take case by case. First we take first case where we will understand the things. We'll be taking f of x is an even function. Means we considered f of x is even function. Okay, so we'll take cases. As per the first property, it says product of two even function or odd function is always even, and the product of an odd and even function will always odd. So as per that, f of x into cos nx we take. Why? I'll tell you. In this case, we can see to obtain a naught, a n, b n, what is required in a function place? Either it will be f of x, or it will be f of x into cos nx, or it will be f of x into sin nx. Here already we have taken f of x, it is even. Okay. If you take f of x is odd, what it means? This product being a product of f of x and cos nx, and it is already proved in the beginning, always cos will be even function, and in this case f of x what we have taken is also even, means it shows that it being a product of both even functions, its result will be even. Then, if we take f of x into sin nx, in this case f of x is even function, and what about sin? Sin is always odd function, means this is the product of an even and odd function, odd function, always it will be odd. Means we can see here f of x is even, f of x into cos nx is even, f of x into sin nx is odd. While calculating a naught, an, bn, what we use? In this case, we use, while calculating a naught, f of x comes, means this is sufficient. So, as per this, we will be getting new results. What are those new results? A naught is equal to, see, 1 by pi into integration between minus pi to plus pi f of x dx. But it is proved that f of x is a even function. So because of that, if you go through the second result, what happens here? Even, if the function is even, it will be taken as 2 times integration between 0 to a pi of x dx. Means here what happens? It will be taken as outside 1 by pi as it is, that into 2 times integration from 0 to pi. Now it will not be between minus pi to plus pi. It will be between 0 to pi into f of x dx. Therefore it is 2 divided by pi integration from 0 to pi into f of x dx. This will be the value for a naught. If the function is proved that the function f of x is even, then we can calculate a naught by using this formula. Similarly, we take an. Previously, what is an? 1 by pi into integration from minus pi to plus pi f of x into cos nx. But we f of x into cos nx is again even. Means as per the second property, it will be 2 times between the range 0 to. So it is 2 times integration from 0 to pi into f of x into cos nx dx. Therefore, it will be taken as 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x into cos nx dx. This will be the formula to calculate an. Now, what about bn? Bn calculation is very, very clear. You can see 1 by pi into bn is integration between minus pi to plus pi f of x sin nx dx. But we know that this product is odd. If it is odd, straight away the result will be 0. Therefore, bn is equal to 0. Means, if, I'll make a note, if the function is, even, we can calculate a naught, an, and where bn is equal to straight away 0. Okay, this is one case. Now we take second case. Case number 2. Now let us take f of x is odd. Okay, f of x is odd. Then the product of f of x into cos nx will be what now? Being a product of cos nx into f of x, where f of x is odd, cos nx is even. So, odd into even will be odd. Okay? Then, f of x into sin nx, where f of x is odd function, sin is always odd. Odd into odd will be even. Therefore, now I take directly. You can see here. Where f of x is concerned, there we need to calculate the value of a naught. Is a naught possible? No. Because of the second property, if it is odd, directly the result will be 0. It is 0. Is an possible? No. Because again it is odd. Is bn possible? Yes, it is possible because it is even. What will be the result? 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x into sin nx dx. So, this will be the result. Okay. Therefore, What is the note here? Note is, if the function f of x is odd, then a naught is directly 0, an is directly 0, only we can calculate bn. These are straight away 0 without any calculation. Previously, when we used routine, the traditional way, there we calculated all the values, whether the function is odd, even we didn't check. But here we need to check the value, and as per that we need to take a decision. Here let us take one more note, most important note, because we can't say all the time the given function will be a single valued function. Sometimes it will be double valued function also. If the given function is double valued function, like f of x is equal to pi of x between minus pi to 0, and it will be xi of x between 0 to pi. Means if you take the given range between minus pi to plus pi, in between it will be 0. So from here to here the function will be pi of x, and from 0 to here the function will be xi of x, if that is the case. Then how to check it out, the nature, odd and even nature of the given function? It is very simple. Now f of x will be taken as even if pi of x, in x, x will be replaced by minus x because the range is between minus pi to plus pi. If it has been replaced, then that must be same as xi of x. Means in a first function, if you replace x by minus x, that should be same as second function. Then it will be known as even. F of x will be known as odd when, if after replacing x by minus x in a first function, that will be same as a second function with opposite sign. Again, calculation of a naught, an, bn depends on this. If it is even, a naught is possible, an is possible, bn will be 0. If it is odd, a naught is 0, an is 0, only bn is possible. Let us discuss the consolidation of this discussion. If the Fourier series of f of x is in between minus pi to plus pi, then what is going to happen? Let us see the scenario. We take nature of the function, even, odd. What will be a naught, an, bn? If the nature of the function is even, when it is even, after replacing x by minus x, we got f of x, so it is even. Then what will be the result? What will be the calculation of a naught? What will be the formula for a naught? That will be 2 divided by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x dx. If it is even, what will be an? An is also possible. That is 2 divided by pi integration from 0 to pi into f of x into cos nx dx. Then what about bn? Bn will be straight away 0 without any calculation because it is even. If the given function is odd, after replacing minus x in first, in the given function we got minus f of x, then what happens? A naught not possible, 0. An not possible, 0. Then only bn is possible. What it will be? 2 divided by pi integration between 0 to pi into f of x into sin nx with respect to x. So this is the calculation. Okay, so in the next session we will be taking few examples to calculate the nature of odd and even function. Then we will proceed with the further results.